Hello everyone, Cookies for Life here, and today I am going to be playing some more Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. So, let's get into this. So there's some rocks here that we can bomb. Let's go ahead and do that, and a chest. So, open the chest. And a traveler's bow. Okay, it's not as good as my soldier's bow, but it's fine, I guess. I just noticed I have full soldier setup. I have soldier's claymore, soldier's bow, and soldier's shield. That's pretty nice. But I don't have the soldier's armor. We can't get that quite yet. That'll be early on in the game, and we need to avoid these Octoroks. I don't really like them, you know. So here we are. A Boko camp. These Bokos seem to be enjoying themselves, but I'm gonna ruin it for them. Explode their bomb. Boom. You right there, Boko. Come on, come on, let's go. Weak. Yeah, let's pick up this and this soldier's broadsword. I'm actually gonna throw away one of these torches. I know I like these torches because you can play with fire, but they are pretty weak. But I got fire on, so yes, it's fine. But let's open up this, and we got a boomerang. I actually want this as well. Say goodbye to the woodcutter's axe. I want to keep one torch. Yay, a boomerang. Oh wait, I didn't read the instruction. This throwing weapon was originally used by the forest-dwelling Koroks. Its unique shape allows it to return after being thrown. Okay, woo! Crap. I didn't catch it. It's on fire. Fire boomerang. This is fun. Like, it goes through the campfire, turns all fiery, and I catch it, turn off the fire, and throw it again, and it turns fiery, and catch it. I'll put the fire and boom. I didn't catch it. Well, I'm gonna grab a torch and let's go. Can we pick this up? Yeah, we can pick it up while having a torch. Okay, I don't want this torch anymore. Go away. I don't need torches anymore. Well, I guess let's head towards that tower. Ooh, maybe we should go there. No, but that's not the right way for Kakariko. We need to go this way. To go to Kakariko Village. Oh look, here's the shrine. How do we approach this? From up here? Glide? Does that work? Yeah, I am professional. So let's go inside and see what trial awaits. We have two spirit orbs, and when we reach Kakariko, there should be another shrine, so we can get four and get a heart container. Well, the water guides, this is an easy shrine, so what you gotta do is use Cryona's room and create a platform onto the next waterfall. Then we freeze this, and you can only freeze it like that because there's no water down there. There's only water for like that. And now we've reached this. This is easy as well. Before we go here, I want to get this chest. And I will show you how to get this chest. You basically just gotta do that. And then climb. Okay, I think it's too high. Oh, come on. I think it's too high up for us to be able to reach it. But, okay, I know what to do. We need to do this. And then another crawling platform like this. And then we climb up and open this chest. Let's see what it holds. A purple ruby. Yeah! Got rupees. Whoop, whoop. Okay, let's go. Okay, so the way you do this is you can see your ball rolling down. So you gotta, like, place a cryonis block here. So it hit. No. Here. So it hits the. This is annoying. Like this. I believe. I don't remember if it's. I think it's like this. And then it like hits the. And goes down to that. Yeah, like that. And then it hits it. But then it falls down there. Oh no, what do we do? You just gotta place the cryonis block below. So now it goes down, but it can't quite reach. So we need another cryonis block. And this is the setup. So you need a cryonis block there, and one there. So then it makes it safely down here. And goes in there. And we can go. And then we can go to the to the monk. The monk is here. So, Hi Hadahama, I believe is his name. So yeah, another spirit orb. A symbol of courage given to those who have overcome the challenges of a shrine. Whoop whoop. That's us. Whoop whoop. These loading screens take so long, and I don't really know what to talk about when I, you know, when they are there, but, you know, we're making, so, this shrine was pretty easy, and there's actually a stable here. Do you see that up there? That's a grog seat. But we can't quite reach it yet. It's too high up. So here's the Dueling Peaks stable. And we have Kukos. Kuko, Kuko. Kuko, Kuko. And we have this guy, Beedle. If you talk to him. Hey, I don't believe I've made your acquaintance. The name's Beedle, but you can call me. Actually, let's just stick with Beedle. But even if you forgot my forget my face, I don't know. I don't think I can. You can remember me by my beetle-shaped backpack. Wow! Despite these dangerous times, you'll find me traveling all over Hyrule to fulfill your shopping needs. I stock many special bugs and must-have items for travelers. And I always charge a fair price, or my name's not Beedle. I also buy all sorts of things if you're in need of rubies. Gemstones in particular fetch a high price. How can I help you today? Look what I've got. What would you like to sell? So you can sell stuff to this guy? Thank you for your business. Do you have anything else? And actually, he really likes beetles, right? No, beetles. So, I believe if we talk to him after this, he'll give us an elixir for the bladed rhino beetle. So yeah. I think. Hey, welcome. Oh, you better have a bladed rhino beetle. Beetle loves bladed rhino beetles. Would you consider giving it to me? You'd get something in return, of course. How about I trade you for this me rice bowl? I thought he only gave elixirs, but apparently he gives all types of food. It's a deal. Yay! Mighty meat and rice bowl. Whoa, thank you so much. You're even more awesome than I thought you were. I will cherish this beetle you have given me for the rest of my days. Anyway, back to business. What are you looking for? Or are you selling? Goodbye. Oh, that's too bad. Hope to see you around. So, in this stable, yes, there are horses. You can... And there are also one of those apples. It was nice and crisp, but don't you hate it when you bite into a soft apple? I do. I love sour and crispy apples, or whatever you can call them. Soft apples, there are no go. And I want them to be never mind. Forget I said anything. So let's catch a horse, shall we? I want to catch this one. Okay, let's see if the other horses are better. Let's see if this one's better. This one, plain old. Let's see if this one's better. This one ain't better. How about one of these? I want one that has at least 3 spurs, but that's probably not gonna... I'm probably not gonna be able to do that here. This guy is mad. This guy is really mad. I think this horse is good, because it really gets mad, you know, really gets mad. So let's see, I got a silence room. Is this a freaking Octrox somewhere? I don't like Octrox, they suck. Go, spam L, spam L, soon. This horse. Alright, let's see. There are plenty of the horses. Like this one. This Octorok. Can you please leave? Get up. Get out of here. Let's pick up this loot. Mighty Carp. And Octobaloons. Yay. Octobaloons, you can use them to make objects float, which is pretty cool. This one seems to be a bit angry as well. Oh, come on. Maybe I'll have to stick with one of the blue ones then. Well, not that I hate the blue ones. My favorite color is blue after all, so I wouldn't be mad keeping one of those. Hello. Oh, this one's good. This one's good. This one has 3 spurs. I will keep this horse. Alright, and I know there's a shrine over here. Stop being so rude. I need to do this. This is the best way to tame a horse. Best way to get Max spawned. You just need to keep on speeding up. it's hard to control it if you keep on speeding up, but if you keep on speeding up and then soothe after you've sped up, you'll make better friends. You'll be better friends. Isn't there a shrine around here? Maybe not. This is the wrong place, isn't it? It's down here. Okay, let's go. Run him over. Kill him. Kill the Boko. Kill the Boko. And this after rock. And let's go. Yeah, I'm saving all these animals right now. I'm nice. Okay, you can leave, please. So there's a shrine. Over this way somewhere. So we need to get to the back to the stable. Come on. I don't know what to call this horse. But I gotta register it. But you guys can come with horse names for horses I'm gonna have in the future, because I won't be staying with this horse forever. I know there's a horse that's better, and I know where to get it. And there's also a pretty big horse. If you've played this game, you probably know what I'm talking about. Welcome to my stable. We deal in all things horse related. We also double as an inn. Huh, I haven't seen your face before. Do you know the stable system? I do, but you guys who haven't played this game or watched like a let's play of it, I'm gonna say I don't. Oh. Then allow me to explain. You can board your horse companions with us and then summon them as you please from our network of stables. You may have come across wild horses during your travels. If you catch one and ride it here to register it, it will become your horse companion. One person can board up to 5 horses, and you're able to swap horses in and out as you please. Do you know how to catch a wild horse? I know how. We caught one. Oh, pardon me. Let me start over. Welcome to our stable. If you've come with a wild horse, you can register it here. It with us here. Or if you want to stay for a rest, please head to the counter inside. What will it be? Register horse. Gotcha. You're sure this is the one? Yes, please. Not a problem. We charge your registration free. I'm sorry. we charge a registration fee to help support our conservation efforts. I'm sorry, everyone. The fee also gets you a locally made saddle and bridle for your horse. The fee is 20 rubies. Is that okay? Yes. Thanks. Please enter a name for your horse. I'm gonna name my horse what should I name it? I'm gonna name it Lightning. No, because it's blue. So why not call it blue? I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna call it blue. Are you sure this is the? Are you sure you want to name this horse blue? Yes. Your registration is complete. Would you like to take your new horse with you? tickles. Thank you. We'll see you next time. Oh, and by the way, if you get separated from your horse, you can whistle and it'll come running. But your horse isn't magic. It can't hear you if you're too far away, so do keep that in mind. Yes, yes, I will. I'm up past my bedtime. We're right near the stable. I can see that look in your eyes, and that you, even if you rest the night, you won't stay for long. I know what it's like to hear the sound of adventure calling your name. I'm selling a few things I've picked up in my travels. Don't cast a look. I'll take a look. This is my finest stuff. Ingredients guaranteed to give you a boost of vigor when you're on the road. Ooh, this... I should have used this when I was farming energetic rhino beetles on my personal file. Oh my god. Well, whatever. I will see. So, we'll remember Bugut for when we need to get energetic rhino beetles. Because we need to get energetic rhino beetles for something important, but that will probably be in a while. Wait, we didn't get the shrine over here. We need to go get that shrine. One second. We will be doing all 120 shrines. And when we do all 120 shrines, that's actually, believe it or not, what we need. The energetic rhino beetles for. That's something we need them when we've done all 120 shrines. Then we need them to upgrade a pretty special item. That's a pretty special armor set that's in the game. So. That'll be pretty helpful. If you've played this already or watched it, you probably already know what I'm talking about. So, I will leave my horse here. And for this shrine, I need remote bomb. I believe it's somewhere around here. Where is it? We'll be able to see some cracked rocks somewhere around here. Isn't it like here or something? Where are the cracked rocks? I believe the shrine's here, isn't it? Isn't the shrine? No, it's further up, isn't it? Yeah, it should be further up, I believe. But my shrine senses are tingling as well. So let's go. We should be able to spot some cracked rocks somewhere around here. Can we spot cracked rocks? Let's see, where are these cracked rocks? There they are. If you go ahead and blow up these cracked rocks, you will find a shrine hiding there behind them. So what I want to do is actually make my way over to this rock. That rock over there. So let's go. And we got a paraglide. And here we are on this rock. Now we throw the bomb, and it should take the stream down towards the cracked rocks. And then when the time is right, we blow up the bomb, and the cracked rocks will break. Oh, it's not yet. Can I actually throw it from over here so it gets close to the cracked rocks? I don't know if we can. Almost. Well, we can't do anything from there. But let's throw these crack this bomb. We need it to reach the crack rocks. Don't get stuck there again. Yeah, it's not gonna get stuck. It'll keep following the stream. And boom. Now we go over here. And there should be a shrine. Yes. So let's see what trial awaits. Maybe it's a blessing? I don't know. But let's see. Barrels and boxes can be pitched around. Use this to your advantage. Okay. So we can push objects around. No, this is not a blessing. Oh, come on. It's one of these. Absolutely despise these. I hate these. That should be it. Now we should be able to pass. But these are so annoying. I suck at this. See these shrines? This is what they do to you. They mess you up. They annoy you so much that you wanna kill yourself. Almost. Oh god. So like this. Like that. Bam. That should be fine. So it doesn't have to match up perfectly unless you're a perfectionist. But then this shrine will be a lot harder. But personally for me, I just want to do it so you can at least pass. So for this one, you gotta do the I believe you gotta reach this chest because it has a small key. Let's line this up. The chest is reachable. Oh god, I just dropped my Joy-Con and then this happened. Turn it around. Like this. And down. Oh no, that. Hold on. That there. Does that work? I need to get my Joy-Con all fixed up real quick because it's all wiggled in. Because I had to do this. As you can see, these shrines are really annoying. Key that can activate, that can open doors and shrines. Alright, let's see how we do this. I have a feeling you need the stairs for something. Does that work? I think that works. I think we might be able to reach it now, but I don't know. Can we use this? We can use this as a tightrope and not quite reach it. So I think what we gotta do is take the staircase over to there, so then we can pass. This shrine sucks. This shrine really sucks. Okay. Down like that. Bam. And stay like that. Now I believe we can pass, and then at that little bit we can yeah, look, like that. And now let's open this up, and here we are. The monk. Tortosa, your shrine sucks, just so you know. But at least we got 4 spirit orbs now. So we can make our way to Kakariko. I know we've spent like 31 minutes on nothing, but it should take like another 5 minutes on horse to reach Kakariko. We just need to get back to our horse real quick. Our little horse, Blue, that's its name. So let's go. So you can see my horse, Blue, is over there. And let's go. Towards Blue we go. Go away, Choo-choo. Don't want to be your friend. And what's this? A sanctuary. Okay. You know, this is really annoying. Ooh, look, these guys are cute. These are like mini stone towers, and they explode, and they give you ambers as well. So you can pick them up, and then you can throw them, and they explode. Poof, and you get a few ambers out of them as well. Come on, get out of the ground. I need you. I need to throw you. Bam. I love these little things. They're so cute. I want this herald herb. Herb, I think herb is how you... Herb? I don't know. Well, let's make our way towards Kakariko Village. What's that glowing thing over there? Oh, that's the top of that. Here we go, little twin bridge. We make our way over little twin bridge. This is actually not where we wanted to go. No, Blue. Come on, Blue. How did you get up here and you can't even get down? Get up again. Okay, actually, don't get up again. Don't you go. I was about to say, aren't you gonna recover your shame? Let's go. Big twin bridge. Where is the beetle going? Beetle. Well, you may be wondering, what do we use these Korok seeds for that you've already collected 4 of? What do we use them for again? I will show you what we use them for. We'll actually find out while we make our way to Kakariko. So what you wanna, the way you wanna go is this way. Pass over this bridge. Kakariko Bridge, yes. This leads to Kakariko Village. Just need to climb up the mountains and you'll get there. Let's go. Do 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 Hey, this is the guy we want to talk to. Why? Because we can use the Korok seed. Shalaka? You can see me? I can see you. Shalasa, Shalaka! It's been 100 years since anyone has been able to see me. I'm Hestu, and I need your help. Those monsters over there stole my beloved Maracas. I think they're still on the other side of those rocks. I can't use my powers without them, Shoko. So please get my Maracas back from them. Okay. The priceless Maracas. Let's go. So, let's start bombing these guys. Yeah, go forget it. Get out of here. Let's bomb these guys. They don't deserve to live. Stealing Maracas from a boy Hestu? That's not nice, man. Surprise! Oh, did he? He almost fell off. I would have loved it if he fell off. Poof! Tree fell. How you can see me, but you can't reach me. Yeet. You can't even throw far enough. And then go to the bomb.
Go to the bomb.
Told you to go to the bomb, man. I told you to go to the bomb. Oh, he fell down. Yay! Boom, he's dead. Your friend is dead. And you shall die. Now. Can you not see me? Poof. Okay, I'm gonna take the fight. These guys are noobs. Let's get Hestu's Maracas back. And let's head back to Hestu and tell him the news. Hello.
Shalakala! Those are my Maracas. Please give them to me. Shalaka! But wait, there's something wrong with my Maracas. The Korok seeds inside are gone. How am I supposed to dance now, Shoko? If I just had one Korok seed, I could sing, dance, and use my powers to help you. You see, I have the power of inventory expansion, so let me know if you find some Korok seeds.
Can we just talk about how much this guy looks like a broccoli? No? You guys don't think so? I think he looks like a broccoli. Just delicious. Let's eat him up. Nom 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 nom. Actually, I'm not gonna eat Hestu. He's pretty important. You know? Or maybe I could steal his Maracas and use them to my advantage. The children of the forest must have taken their Korok seeds from my beloved Maracas. I never thought I'd be the target of one of their pranks, Shoko. But wait. Do you have a Korok seed? You do! You got a Korok seed from one of the forest children. If you'll give me just one Korok seed, I'll make your inventory bigger in return. Yes, please.
Shalaka! So which stash do you want more slots in?
I want more slots in the weapon stash.
Oh yeah! Shaky shaka! Weapon stash has been expanded. Shalaka. I still smell Korok seeds on you.
You want me to expand your inventory again? Yes, please, my rose stash.
Oh yeah, shaky shaka. Your bow stash has been expanded. Shalaka! Oh, look at the time. I need to get back before Grandpa yells at me. Shoko. Sorry, I have to go, but I still need Korok seeds, so bring them some to Korok Forest if you find any.
Okay. This video is longer than other videos I've done, but, so, I'm gonna end this here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you all in the next video.